Howdy chaps, welcome back to Tomahawk. I have once again risen from the dead. Today we are going to review the tortoise. Let's go. Let's see the tortoise, with a need for speed, roll slowly towards the damage greed. Although you cannot get anywhere fast, if played correctly the tortoise is a blast. Don't always forget to check your flank. Otherwise the enemy will give you a bud spank. Now my rapping days are over, and let's be a bigger defender than a Land Rover. This rhyme does not even fit to this beat, but Tomahawk made me say it anyway. So, let's actually get started then. The Tortoise is a tier 9 British tank destroyer, that when played like a true wannabe unicorn, can even make the life of tier 10s harder than life on the Belarusian border. At the same time you must not get cocky like Lewis Hamilton, and play with your brain instead of your balls. Your situational awareness must always be top notch. Reading the mini-map is essential to your survival. When turning around, make sure not to expose your flank. Once again your survival depends on your strong frontal armor. Queen Elizabeth does not approve of you showing your sides. That is probably why Prince Charles is still not a king. What a pleb. Against tier 7s you can literally laugh your ass off, as long as you keep facing them. Tier 8s can be trolled as well, although be aware of gold rounds. Tier 9s can be contested when you are peeking, and tier 10s can only be farmed from distance, or when you are able to track them with your DPM. Trading, in general, only makes sense with people with low rate of fire. Trick them into shooting your strong parts, and you are likely to return fire at least twice. With sniper-like accuracy and decent damage, you can make them cry harder than a jury member on American talent shows when a contestant is telling another sad story. As you can see here, the noob Tomahawk is getting himself into more problems than the UK after Brexit. Never allow someone to circle you. Always back up as fast as you can to block the road, like that container ship in the Suez Canal. Then turn again and make them cry. Checking where your team is going in the beginning of the battle is also important. You don't want to be alone, since loneliness can kill, especially old people. You want to take the initiative, but you still need your buddies to draw fire as well. If you are the sole target, people will push you, or spam the poor commander with heat shells. The only thing that will give you is a repair bill and a free ticket to the garage. You have two arch enemies on tier 9. The T-95 and the Jag Tiger. They can penetrate you more reliably than a porn star. The advantage you have over the T-95 is your rate of fire, and generally better accuracy. You sit at all times. Your better rate of fire has no use if you do not penetrate your shells. The difference in making the tortoise work is to bounce the receiving shot, and dishing out every time you can. Therefore do not be afraid to shoot some special rounds. Your tank becomes extremely scary later in the battle, when the enemy is low on hit points and you have conserved the majority of yours. This allows you to trade more effectively than a merchant. Remove your enemy like removing the YouTube dislike button. The joke's on you, I guess. You aim for the tracks of your opponents, in order to immobilize them. When they repair, fucking do it again. Your rate of fire can punish anyone that has not invested in repair skills. Then they sit there like a vegetable in a wheelchair, saliva dripping out of their mouth corners. Farm them harder than any peasant has ever done. When not brawling, your accuracy can even work to snipe a bit. Once again, be wary of Jag Tigers. Their accuracy allows them to snipe your cupola reliably. When you are playing with the tortoise, you need to accept that sometimes you are just like a tourist on a trip. You can have multiple minutes of sightseeing before even having anything to shoot your pictures at. This is the reality of the modern world of tanks. You will not be able to have a good game every single game, and it is not even your fault. As Keanu Reeves would say, you are fabulous. When you set up your ammo loadout, make sure to take a healthy load of all ammo types. An APCR a day keeps the doctor away. This allows you to be flexible in your gameplay. Whether it be soft light tanks, lightly armored mediums, or a heavy brawling stalemate. The one I had with your mom last night. With the equipment loadout you have multiple choices. Just like on any university test. I run the following setup. Ventilation on the first slot, rammer and modified configuration. Reason being that enemies of the British Empire like to immobilize you and circle you. This equipment piece allows you to surprise your enemy more than any corona lockdown session your local government has decided on. Just when they think they nailed you, after you have used your repair kit, your speedy repair allows you to ride once again. Enjoy the feeble tries of your enemies trying to outplay you. You cannot bullshit a bullshitter. If you are a big fan of the tortoise and grind it all the way, I recommend the following setup for the field modifications. This will strengthen the strengths of your tank, and make it even harder for your enemies to deal with. Now you know how to play to tortoise. This is the correct way. Use your breakthrough potential and use those hit points when necessary. Go out there, and shoot at vegetables in wheelchairs. Thank you for watching, you absolute juicy tomatoes. Thanks for sticking with me for all these years. I hope you liked it. Please feel free to check out more content on the left or right. Or heck, maybe even subscribe. For now, thank you and fuck off.